precision instrument approach is a navigation system that provides both lateral and vertical guidance to an aircraft during its approach to landing phase, especially during instrument meteorological conditions, such as low visibility or ceilings. The instrument landing system, or the ILS, is one of the most commonly used type of precision instrument approach. It's a ground-based airport navigation aid, where the range information is provided by marker beacons, and visual guidance is provided by specific approach landing configurations. The standard instrument approach can be dissected into different approach segments. The first segment is the arrival segment, which takes the pilot from the en route structure to the initial approach fix. This is the segment where the aircraft can be configured for the imminent approach. Before reaching the initial approach fix, the pilot must slow down the aircraft to its approach speed, get the updated weather reports, complete the descent checklist, and the avionics setup, including tuning to the correct ILS and the communication frequencies. Pilots must also complete the approach briefing prior to initiating the instrument approach procedure. Today, I'll be discussing the ILS Runway 11 approach to Lawrence Hanscom Field at Bedford. The first section I will look at is the arrival segment of the approach. In our case, the arrival segment uses feeder fixes. We have three separate arrival segments. The first one is noted by the Manchester VOR, flying inbound on the 215 radial, which is about 24 nautical miles to Zelf intersection. The minimum en route altitude, or MEA, to be flown here is 2,000 feet when we are on the segment and when ATC clears us for the approach. The second arrival segment for us is the Lawrence VOR that takes on the 249 radial at 1,900 feet MEA to Zelka intersection, which is about 25 nautical miles from the Lawrence VOR. The final arrival segment for us would begin from the Bronk intersection, transitioning on the 111 radial at 2,300 feet to the Lobby intersection, which is our other initial approach fix of the approach, at about 5.1 nautical miles from the Bronk intersection. Once the descent checklist is complete, the aircraft is prepared for the initial approach segment. This segment is defined by the portion of the approach that is between the initial approach fix and the intermediate approach fix. The approach here at Bedford has more than one initial approach segment. One of these segments involves arriving at the Zelka intersection and doing a parallel entry to a holding pattern in lieu of procedure turn of 1 minute legs, as indicated. Here the pilot will fly outbound on a 293 radial, do a standard rate of turn to the right, and then fly inbound to intercept the 113 radial while descending to maintain 1,900 feet at Zelka intersection, which is now the intermediate approach fix. Another option for the initial segment of this approach is to begin at the Lobby intersection. The procedure for using this option is to fly inbound 0.9 nautical miles from Lobby on a 113 radial to Zelka intersection, which is the intermediate approach fix. There is no procedure turn authorized for this approach, and the aircraft descends from 2,300 feet to 1,900 feet when intersecting Zelka. The next segment of this precision approach is the intermediate segment. On a precision approach, this segment begins at the intermediate approach fix, extending to the final approach segment, or the interception of the glide slope. If on ATC radar vectors, the segment begins when the final approach course is intercepted until the interception of the final approach fix. On this segment, the aircraft must be properly configured for landing, and the pilot must ensure that the before landing checklist is completed. This is also the time when the communication is usually passed from the approach control to the tower control, or to the common traffic advisory frequency. In the case of our approach, this segment begins at Zelka intersection, which is the intermediate approach fix. Here, the pilot is expected to fly on a 113 radial for 6.2 nautical miles, descending down to 1,800 feet in order to reach at Jokpo intersection, which is our final approach fix. The final approach segment of a precision approach begins from the interception of the glide slope, indicated with a lightning bolt symbol, and not the final approach fix indicated using the Maltese cross. Though in our case, both falls on the same point, which may not be always true. At this point, the pilot completes the final configuration checklist, and the pilot must start to maintain a stabilized approach by making small corrections to stay on the localizer and the glide slope needles. In our example, the pilot should begin to track the glide slope at Jokpo that occurs at 1,800 feet and continue down to the runway once provided he is established on the localizer. Here, the pilot should start timing the approach in case the glide slope fails. Timing is the only way to identify the missed approach point in case we lose the glide slope, allowing the pilot to continue on a localizer-only approach. The pilot will only continue to descend past the decision height of 382 feet provided he has a runway environment in sight, and if not, he should initiate the missed approach procedure. The final segment of the precision approach is the missed approach segment. This segment starts from the missed approach point until the aircraft reaches the published missed approach fix, or until further coordination with the ATC can be accomplished. When going missed, the pilot must configure the aircraft for the missed approach and continue to climb and fly as published. The pilot must also advise the ATC upon executing missed approach procedure, so final instructions can be given by the ATC. Complete the segment by holding as published, following ATC instructions and completing all appropriate checklists. In our example, if the pilot decides to go missed upon reaching the decision height of 382 feet, the pilot can execute a published missed approach by climbing to 1,000 feet and then executing a climbing left turn to 2,000 feet on a heading of 350 to intercept a 223 radial that takes him to the CMOD intersection for doing a holding pattern.